Manual evaluation in Azure AI Studio enables you to continuously iterate and evaluate your prompt against your test data in a single interface. You can import data or choose one of your previous existing datasets in your project. In this demo, the Contoso customer support team plans to leverage a new custom copilot that can answer inquiries about customers and their purchase history. I'll execute a manual evaluation to validate the accuracy of the model's responses. I'll first set up the system message for my deployed model. The system message reads, "Act as a conversational customer support assistant who helps our customer support team learn more about Contoso customers and their purchase history. Your responses should be informative, polite, and relevant." In the Configurations tab, I'll select my deployed model and ground the model with customer data that's available in my customer's index. Now that I've configured my prompt, I'm ready to upload my dataset of sample input. In the Import Test Data wizard, I'll upload my customer's manual evaluation file and then map the data for the input and expected response fields. I'll now click Run to generate the model outputs to the sample inputs. Now that I have output from the model, I'll go row by row to compare the expected response to the output and select either the thumbs up or thumbs down icon. While evaluating the outputs, I came to realize that I'm not too fond of how the model formats customer purchase history. Although the output is accurate, I'd prefer the model to only include the product name, quantity, and price of the product. In addition, I'd like the output to be in bullet points. Also, I think it'd be useful for the model to provide two suggested follow-up questions. This should help encourage our customer support team to dive a bit deeper into learning about Contoso customers. With that said, I'll mark the two outputs about purchase history with a thumbs down to indicate that the responses weren't to my preference and therefore fine-tuning is needed. And finally, the final output here is fine. I'll save this evaluation for future reference in case I want to compare results after making some changes. I'll now modify the system message to include my formatting preferences and then run the evaluation once more for the two rows that have a thumbs down. The model now generates an output that follows my preferred formatting. To get started with manual evaluation, visit ai.azure.com.